Too open. Too open.
Missed three games early in the year due to illness in that starting lineup now for the third straight game. Grossell inside, got good position against Bradley Hayes. It's the block, and now Watson will push to the other end of the floor. Thomas, the trailer, on the attack, ripped out of his hands by Isaac Copeland. Here's Seardon, the step in two. And the Blue Jays take the early lead. To me, Seardon's kind of the catalyst for Creighton.
Around to Copeland, who feeds Bradley Hayes. A matchup we'll watch all night. The two picks inside, and Hayes so improved this year, can't connect on the hook, and there's Watson for the rebound.
This is where Creighton's lethal in transition.
Oh, what a pass, and the finish by Kyrie Thomas.
You see what getting a deep, but the transition game is huge for Creighton. Watch Maurice Watson come in and scoop the loose ball rebound and push it, and the vision is where he's outstanding. Great find to Kyrie Thomas. But that includes Villanova, Xavier, everybody. But I think they're trying to find their defensive toughness. I thought Hopkins and Trowick's departures really left a void in that department.
Milliken will try.
From the corner, Milliken off the bench with a three.
He's playing great.
He had 30 total points in his first 3 years. He has scored, including tonight, 137 this year as Seardon gets the home roll and gets the three to give the four right now for Creighton with Milliken and Hegner on the floor. Milliken attacking, Copeland goes reverse, and Milliken off the bench providing a spark. He's got five. 17 shoot for Milliken. Smith Rivera on top of him, good deflection by Cameron into the backcourt. 10 to shoot for the Blue Jays. Watson's going to have to hurry. He'll launch the three and hit.
But not his game. Doesn't want to take a lot of three-point jump shots.
So he picks and chooses his spots. When he's in rhythm and he's got space, he'll let it fly.
Extra pass to Harrell. Nothing there. Out to Milliken, who's had the hot hand, and he continues.
3 for 3 from the floor. 2 for 2 from the line. He's got 10.
And a nice blow with the rebound for Creighton.
5-point Blue Jay lead. Harrell attacking inside, using the left hand to get 2. Skip into the corner. Cameron playing with those 2 fouls and he throws it away. Seardon with the intercept. In transition, the three. And the Jays have taken a 10-point lead.
In transition, getting the turnover. Seardon leads the team in steals. It's not exactly this, that no, yes shot from the coaching staff.
LJ Peak stays with it. That's the rebound into the hands of Watson. Watson always on the run to the other end. And Maurice Watson Jr. with 2 more.
A little bit more of late. Another one of the talented young faces on this Georgetown roster.
Georgetown hanging around with good 3-point shooting. 7 of 10 from 3 as Watson gets an open free throw line jumper. And he'll stick it. He's got 7.
But if they're going to get out and pressure Maurice Watson all the times here. Again, that's been the biggest difference between good Georgetown and not so good Georgetown is their ability to defend.
Jays have made 6 out of their last 8 as they work it inside, lost the ball. Grossell gets it back and puts it in. Coming up on 1 minute to go in the first. Grossell inside, spins on Gobert, and the left hand gives Creighton the 2-point.
Big man running the floor hard and headed it against the glass. What a great defensive effort.
Grossell with the tip. And here come the Blue Jays. Watson driving in. Feels the contact and finishes against Derrickson.
That did a good job of going and seeking out Derrickson, understanding that he's got 2 personal fouls. And back up or close the space.
11 for Smith Rivera.
Down for Puff. And out to Watson. 15 on the shot clock. Gotta move it here. Watson driving inside against Hayes, and Watson finishing. He's got 11. Maurice pick and roll is finding him. The roll man. I like the Bradley Hayes' game. What a story, as you mentioned earlier. Not seeing much time in high school, not seeing much time in his first 3 years in Georgetown. Thomas got it on the hook and gets the three.
off the previous nine turnovers. Ronnie Harrell. Around the head of the screen.
Left alone, wide open three. He'll shoot that.
Yeah, he's played well. And this is a game. This is a big statement out in recruiting. It's not just about finding good players. It's about finding good players that fit your system. And Go Van, perfect for what Georgetown wants to do. Watson with the answer from the foul line.
Timeout situation. It was the first called timeout of the second half. So regardless, that's a full. That's why you have the back-to-back TOs.
It's the floater down the baseline. And the Creighton Blue Jays are back on top. 52-50.
One dribble back out to Watson. At the elbow. Oh, has he been good tonight or what?
16 for Maurice Watson.
But he's taking...
Give him the mid-range jumper there. Govan steps up the floor. Never want to do that. Watson in traffic finds Seared an open three. He's fouled. LJ Peak with the foul on Zierden's three-point shot. And Zierden's struggling of late from behind the arc. Now he's going to get three free throws.
And maybe he's getting to see the ball go through the net three times will help him. Great job by Zierden relocating. Finding an angle to free himself up for Maurice Watson to collapse the defense. And good shooters, you can't just camp out on the three-point line, Kevin. You've got to be able to move without the ball to free yourself up.
89.7% at the line this year.
One more to come for Zoo.
McDermott or JT3 was going to steal the break here for Devontae Smith-Rivera, Maurice Watson with the 8-minute media time. If one of them would have done it, the other one would have done it as well, but it didn't happen. So here comes the crowd.
8-0, bring them up.
Possession. A good success for Maurice Watson getting into the paint, making plays.
Georgetown now on an almost 3-minute drought.
Zierden. Inside. Zach Hanson for two more.
A great action, double ball screen, can't help off Hagner, nobody at the rim, and Zach Hanson delivers. Creighton on a run here in Omaha.
With the finish, he's got five. Watson going quickly to the other end. Zierden. Watson now, open three.
Look how fast the transition. You can't do a little home run trot or feel good about yourself if you're eventually going to that man. He's now got 17.
Convert on the three-point play remains a six-point
Creighton lead.
Coming up on 3 minutes to go in Omaha. Watson to the other end. Gets the roll.
I love that. So many teams would start and still got 2.5. The ball knocked away.
Seared it with the scoop, and he saves it for the Blue Jays.
Some outstanding individual efforts defensively. Purcell on the possession for the nice hand. Seared with the pick and the dive.
Seared. Noticeably limping as he comes up the floor, and as he had to leap for that high pass, you could see the grimace on his face as he came down.
Good second decision from Zierden to dive here. Get a piece of it. First to the floor usually gets it. Copeland didn't dive. Zierden did. Creighton basketball. Good hands from Zierden, who leads the team at steals.
Front end of the one-on-one is good for Watson. That was the Creighton getting it done at the line tonight. And they've outshot the Hoyas at the line 19-7. And they have outmade the Hoyas at the line.
Here's Pete. 18 to shoot. The pass deflected.
Rivera.
Been really locked in and active and high hands to disrupt the vision for the roll man. Had Govan down the pipe there. And Zierden with the high hands gets a deflection and gets another steal for Creighton.
That's three turnovers for Georgetown in the last 1 minute and 28 seconds. Continuing. Creighton just cashing in on these turnovers. They're 15 Georgetown turnovers. Creighton scored 24 points off the turnovers. Characteristic, Creighton's not a team that typically turns
people over a lot, but they're locked in tonight.
Greg McDermott.